If you've brought me in here to sweet talk me...
It's only a few days until the end of term.
That's not the point. It can't be one rule for the teachers and another for the pupils. You're a deputy head. One with aspirations of becoming a head teacher. Can't help but think that George has got something to do with this.
He may have slightly influenced my decision. We've just been arguing so much recently, and what with my arrest.
Has something happened between you two again?
No. I just thought it would be a good idea to get some space.
So you were going alone?
Yeah. That would be good to clear my head. But you're right, it's completely unprofessional.
Well, on the other hand, I mean, it's been an unusual year. And I don't suppose that losing you for a couple of days will make much difference.
So
if anyone asks, I know nothing.
Thank you.
Some alone time will do you good.
Granny wouldn't go anywhere without a bag of boiled sweets. She had pockets full of them when she died.
I feel so bad lying to Sally. She only let me have the time off because she thinks I'm going alone.
Anything to get you away from me, eh?
No, she just thinks I need to work on myself.
Well, no arguments there.
Which is why I've decided to lay off the booze while we're away. I really do want to be a good boyfriend.
There you go, then. You're doing exactly what you told her you would.
She'd still be fuming.
Are you going to be like this the entire time? Because if you don't want to go away with me, you can just say...
No, I'm sorry. There is nothing I want more than to be sat in a hot tub with you in those tiny blue trunks that I saw you put in your bag, okay?
Good. Because there's nothing that I want more than to spend an entire week alone with you. In fact, I'd be quite happy if I didn't see anyone else for the rest of my life.
Me neither.